Hello and good evening. I'm Marsha D'Souza and you're watching Goa 365. Our headlines for the day. Opposition takes on the government for excessive fees paid to Advocate General of Goa. Goa prohibition of ragging bill becomes an act. Law Minister cornered over the functioning of his department. Government to hand over investigations into stoning of Panjim police station and ransacking of MLA's house to CBI. Now the news in detail. On the second day of budget session of Goa Assembly, opposition demanded action and recovery of fees paid to Advocate General Supoth Kantak for committing fraud on the exchequer by charging fees even after disposal of cases.
Saligaon MLA Dilip Parulekar brought to the notice of Law Minister Dayanand Narvekar how the Advocate General has charged fees after the disposal of writ petition number 3 of 2005.
Writ petition number 3 of 2005, a writ petition disposed of Kala 01052006, serial number 3, and 2006 salan, 5 mahinyan disposed zalyanantar, amcha agent, and je taka accompany karpache je advocate asat. तंजानी
ओकरा खेपा फी घेतले
ते झाल्यानंतर तरी असताना ओकरा बराफारी फी काढलेली असा.
Speaking further on this issue, leader of opposition Manohar Parekar listed out different cases where AG had used similar modus operandi to charge twice for the same hearing.
मका अनेक वडलो फ्रॉड तकले नडून देऊंग जाय वो ऍडव्होकेट जनरल किने करता ते आऊ नको. सिरियल नंबर ॲडव्होकेट जनरलची फीचे लिस्ट काढा पेज नंबर 7 सिरियल नंबर 32 33 34. दोन पाचाक अपियरन्स दाखयला, 3-5 हीच केस, 3-5 अपियरन्स दाखयला आणि 5-4 अपियरन्स दाखयला. आता स्पीकर सर, यू रिफर सिरियल नंबर 93 94 95. They are repetition of 32 33 and 34. एकाच अपियरन्साक, एकाच दिसा, एकाच केसीक दोन दोनदा फी क्लेम केला. स्पीकर सर, तर ही एकूण तीनूच नाही केसी. रिफर सिरियल नंबर 65 and 66. बोथ हॅव बीन क्लेम्ड अगेन, 17-18-2005 हॅज बीन क्लेम्ड अगेन एट सिरियल नंबर 125 and 126. ऐक दाखयता इतल्याचेरूच सोपून ना. सिरियल नंबर 45 46 49 51 54 58 61 62 आर अगेन क्लेम्ड ॲट 106 107 110 112 115 119 122 and 123. टोटली 13 खेपा अपियरन्स डबल क्लेम झाले असा.
मांद्रे MLA लक्ष्मीकांत पारसेकर ट्राई टू थ्रो मोर लाइट ऑन AG's फ्रॉड.
आम्ही एकच भितरलो अभ्यास केला, 3 of 5. ती केस 18 फावटी आफ्टर डिस्पोजल 18 फावटी त्याका पे केला. म्हणजे डिस्पोज झाले केस 1-5-2006 आणि 1-5-2006 नंतर 18 फावटी एजी दर फावटीक 8,000 प्रमाणे पे केला.
पारेकर डिमांडेड ऍक्शन अगेन्स्ट द ऍडव्होकेट जनरल अँड रिकव्हरी ऑफ द मनी.
ही साळेलीची केस 108 खेपा एकाच दिसा एकूच हिअरिंग झाले, 108 बिलां किती चालला. विल यू रिकव्हर अँड टेक ऍक्शन.
Replying to the queries raised by the opposition bench, Law Minister Dayanand Narvekar meekly assured the assembly that he would ask Chief Secretary to conduct inquiry into the matter.
If whatever allegations are made, it looks prima facie very serious.
You are not making allegations.
I will see that Chief Secretary inquires into all these details, because often I am not able to make out what is correct or what is wrong, because it looks like every even after disposal it looks like the claims are there. Why it is made, for what is the purpose, only AG will be able to tell.
He is a member of the House.
Goa Legislative Assembly yesterday passed Goa Prohibition of Ragging Bill in educational institutions in the state.
The draft bill proposes stringent punishment against those indulging in ragging, like expulsion from the institute, refusal of admission in any other institute for 3 years following conviction of ragging, withholding of results and scholarships, and debarring from participation in events. The head of the institute will be the final authority to decide upon complaints of ragging, and his or her decision will be final. However, if the head of the institute does not take any action against a complaint of ragging within 7 days, then the head of the institute would also be treated as an abettor of ragging and will be liable for disciplinary action. All prospectors of every institute will have to publish a caution that ragging is banned. Students seeking admission will have to give an undertaking that they will not indulge in ragging, and the institutes will have to constitute a proctorial committee comprising of senior faculty members and responsible senior students to keep a watch and vigil over ragging. Besides, every migration certificate issued will have to mention whether the concerned student had indulged or not in ragging. The need for such an act was necessitated due to persistent demand from parents of the victims and other like-minded members of the society to the government to initiate immediate remedial measures to curb the nuisance in educational institutions. Most of the time, it is the junior students who become victims of the senior students but go unnoticed, as complaints from junior students are not forthcoming. In such instances, students are physically manhandled, thereby leading to psychological imbalance, and the victims tend to discontinue studies. The credit for the draft bill becoming an act should go to the former Pirne MLA Jitendra Deshprabhu, as in the year 2006 he had moved a private member's bill to prevent ragging in colleges in Goa and withdrew it when the then government had promised to take up the issue. It finally saw the light of the day.
We'll spill into a small break. Stay with us.